Speaker, eminent speaker, Dr. R.C. Sharma is already there, and he's going to start without any break, without any delay, because his session is also going to be equally very significant, because he's a man from the world. He worked in different countries, in different universities of this world, and he's bringing OER, OER in India, that is the open education resource. So before we will give a final gratitude to ma'am, if any question, yeah, please can read out my organizers. Yeah.
Sir, there is one question. Like, I also want to know that which software or app is best for shortening the size of videos. If we made a video that is 600 MB, what we have to upload up to 300 MB, that what we will do?
Then you can embed the video through R.C. Sharma is listening to me. He can give the answer, sir. We can synchronize the file, and we can embed the file, video file, according to the space.
Okay, perhaps let me share my screen and go there. Actually, friends, you may be seeing my screen now. When I was listening to Vandana ji, there is an opportunity for you. Let me type that name into the chat box. There is a good opportunity for you. Only, I think today is 25th, so you have got 4 days only. This is a good video editing software, ACDC Video Studio 3. If you know about Camtasia, which is a proprietary software, number one in terms of video editing, but for that you need to pay. The company, it has made it free to download until 29th of July. So I suggest that you all just go to this website and download this. Not only that, along with it, here you will see the various products. So just to shorten your video from one format or its size, you can use Format Factory. So this Format Factory, it will allow you to convert, or even, personally, the software which I use, it is VSDC, Video Editor. This one. So you can try this. They are wonderful softwares. They can do many, many things, including chroma key effect and all those. And here you can see the video converter is there, audio converter is there. The video editor is there. So, and these are free downloads and not heavy files, around 40 MB, something like that. Yes, Prerana ji, the things which I have told you are free, except this one, ACDC, which the company has given you up till 29th of July to download it free. And it is a full-fledged package. You just need to, put your email ID here, and then it will send you the key. The access key, those I think it is around 20 letters, the key, the password for that, which you need to use it to register it there. Okay, that's
thank you, sir. Thank you very much. It is really amazing. Even it was a discovery for me as well. Although I used to be very much savvy in these kind of things, being connected with the e-learning from last 4 to 5 years, but it was a new discovery. Thanks a lot. Immediately after your session at the lunchtime, I am going to be download. I think many of my participants are also going to be download after your session. So thank you very much, Dr. Vandana Punia.
Sir, I have a question. I have a small question which I am eagerly for asking. Okay. If you kindly allow me.
I'll allow you, but otherwise nobody is allowed to come on a mic and do this, because the session is very limited timing. Yeah, please. Okay, only one question.
Okay. Just 1 minute. Thank you for allowing me to ask the question. Thank you, Punia Madam, for your amazing presentation and informative to all of us. Now, actually, I am Professor Sarkar from GIS Group, Kolkata. I used to take the live classes to my students in Google Meet and uploading the lectures in Google Classroom. That we used to follow in my GIS group in Kolkata. Now in Google Meet, while sharing the video to the students, but we face a problem that the students can see the video but not the audio is not audible to them. So that problem we are facing in Google Meet, since you have referred the instrument, the Google Meet, one of the live class tool in the online classes. So what is the solution of that? Because students can watch the video, but that cannot, they cannot hear the sound. So if you kindly give the solution of that, please.
Dr. Vandana, if you allow me to be speak on this, may I speak?
Yes, sir.
Ah, thank you. Yeah, I read your this query even on the chat box. I didn't want to be reply. I'll tell you, this must be a technical problem with your gadget or device. If you say I can go now to Google Meet immediately from my this screen sharing, and I will speak because I'm continuously taking classes on a Google Meet without any hurdle, without any glitches, audio as well as video. Only the issue, I'll tell you.
I'm not telling that. I can take the live class in Google Meet. Student can. I am audible to the students. That I'm not asking. My question is very specific. Suppose there is an Amitabh Bachchan talk of motivation speech. So while starting the very beginning the classes, very beginning of the classes, I used to run the video of Amitabh of some motivational classes. Now they can watch the video, but they cannot listen the audio talk of that video which I am sharing my screen, but they can hear my talk. So that technical problem I am facing, that we all, rather I would say the all. So that I do not know what will be the solution.
Does mean that on a Google Meet you want to play some video on your screen and you want to make that your video to be go and play with the same? No, sir, it is not. You want to bring a Film City free of cost at your home. No, it is not possible. It is not possible. Today morning, if you joined in time, have you heard the music? I have given a background music. I have given a PPT. Everything was very much clear to all of you. I think most of the participants can write on a chat box. Sir, the problem is that even today, when ma'am, she was trying to be play a video, there is a proper link. When you are going to be play a video, they will disconnect you from your outer world and your video will be definitely going to be broadcast. Of course, that needs some technical things, which I cannot take it over here, but it is very much feasible. I will request someone in GIS only, maybe Kavya or someone, those are very much prominent on this kind of things, Sila or Randa, they can help you out and we will do it.
In that case, instead of selecting the application window, if you try to select entire window, means entire screen, because sometimes what happens that if you select a particular application, there are two options. You select entire screen or application. The application part sometimes, the only difficulty, if you means be careful, when you select entire screen and if there are many things on your screen, on your desktop, anytime whenever you switch something, those things will be visible.
We always used to take the window, not the entire screen. And same problem we are not facing in Zoom video, Zoom Live or the BlueJeans or the GoToMeeting. But only thing this problem I am facing in Google Meet. That's why I'm telling to share. Actually, if you can. Okay. Anyway, you have confirmed me.
Google Meet have some technical issue or maybe sometime device. But I think it's something new. Thank you for your concern, and it has been taken well, and we will even reply you through email also. I will do some troubleshooting and I will check it out. So now I request our Dr. Mahiraj, my colleague, my friend, head of the Department of Electrical Engineering, NIT Uttarakhand, to please give a welcome to our next speaker, Professor R.C. Sharma ji, for his session. Please, Dr. Mahiraj.
A very good afternoon to all, and it's a great pleasure for me to introduce Dr. Ramesh Chandra Sharma, Professor Ambedkar University. Dr. Ramesh Chandra Sharma is an associate professor at Ambedkar University. He has a broad area of expertise in topics like e-learning, instructional design, open educational resources, open and distance learning, teacher education, educational technology, and educational research. Dr. Ramesh also holds a PhD in educational technology. He has published many articles based on distance learning and online methods of teaching. He also has a history of teaching at renowned national and international institutions across the world. Some of them include WASM Open University, Malaysia, University Brazil, University of Fiji, and Indira Gandhi National Open University, India, Choturam College of Education, Haryana, and other colleges also in India. Now I want to give the online platform to Professor Ramesh Chand Sharma to share his views and
Welcome, sir. Now it's your show, please.
I was muted. So thank you Mahirajji, and thank you Dr. Saab. This is a very interesting topic of OER, but I think that sometimes we don't get the opportunity to learn related things. So I have modified my presentation a bit, and before we go into the actual field of OER, I'm thinking that we can see somehow some of the things which are related to that in this field, because of we as a teacher, as a researcher, and as a learner, we have to deal with many things which are related to it. So first of the thing which we should be aware of are some of the related terms and areas in which we work. So perhaps you may be aware that in India we do have a national IPR policy, which was accepted and approved by the cabinet in 2015, around 5 years ago. This the basic purpose of this IPR national policy is to protect our intellectual property. The reason being is that had we not been strict and aware about our own things, वो आप लोगों को बड़ी मुश्किल होने वाली थी कि नीम हमारा नहीं रहता, अनाज हमारा नहीं रहता, ढेर सारी चीजें, इवन हल्दी के ऊपर भी कुछ बाहर के भाई लोगों की निगाह थी, दैट ट्राई टू पेटेंट दोस थिंग्स. इट इज द क्रेडिट टू आवर गवर्नमेंट एंड सम अवेयर पीपल हु वर चेकिंग, एंड पर्टिकुलरली आफ्टर दैट WTO एंड दोस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स इन द इंडस्ट्री साइड, इन द बिजनेस वर्ल्ड, थिंग्स वर मूविंग इन अ वेरी शॉडी एंड शेडी मैनर. So then the governments, the related departments, they had to act fast and protect. Otherwise, few of our indigenous technologies, our indigenous products, even the yoga, means I don't know why the people call it yoga. It is yoga actually. So, but maybe the English word is more popular there. It originated with us. But the claim is being taken by Western countries only. They are more popular than our own Babaji, Baba Ramdev, like that. So that way, these things, they become very much important. It has certain objectives, with the purpose which it serves for us, that what is the benefit of we should be, how we can extend the outreach and promote our IPRs to save them. So that means, and it, because it is based on our various kind of interests, which can be social, which can be cultural, which can be economic, something like that. And then the kind of knowledge is generated in our institutions to protect it from being misused by others. There are various things we will see very soon, which come into that way. So that nobody, and particularly nowadays, you maybe might have already noted it, that the hackers around the world, and particularly they are believed to be the Russian hackers this time. I don't know why the Chinese hackers, they were not publicized for that act. It is believed that they are trying to steal, they are trying to hack the networks to find the cure for COVID-19, the coronavirus, because various laboratories around the world, various scientists around the world, they are seriously working on that. And it is networked world. So the things they are happening, that the hackers nowadays, it is a very recent news that they are trying to steal the formula if somebody has developed it, because the news are coming up, including in India also, that we have, we are in a much better position in a advanced stage of creating a medicine for this virus like that. So we should be vigilant, we should be careful about it, that nobody takes it. But something, if something goes wrong in some way, still if something happens, what are the legal and legislative frameworks available to protect that person? Either it is the, means the interest of an individual which is getting affected, or the interest of an institution which is getting affected from there, to protect it, to provide them the legal mechanisms to safeguard their interest and safeguard our own knowledge. And that is the purpose. But to reach to that stage, we need to know that what are various administrative steps to follow. If we need to protect something, how to protect it? If something has gone wrong, what should be done? To whom we need to approach? How the application is filed? How the process is to be taken further? Those kind of things. We need to be aware of those things. And then once it is, something comes up, there is a triangle of, we have the creators who create the things, the innovators who take the lead into it, and the users. Triangle, the three-party connections there, to allow them to make a better use of their knowledge, their product, their content in somewhat way, and to take it to the next level, to mass level or to a commercial level, to develop something there. You may be knowing that in India we have a famous, and particularly perhaps I'm not sure, but maybe. The credit goes to Punjab, maybe it originated from there. You must have heard that term called as Jugaad. So we are very much, in fact, long back when I was a regional director of IGNU in Karnal, and we had a center in Ambala, there was this person, he was trying to find out a solution of having something related to some equipment, and he tried, many people try to get it, rectified. Repaired, he failed. Ultimately, he went to Ambala. There, he found certain, our local engineers, and they, within no time, they repaired that machine. So, due to some jugaad, like in the older days, if you know that we had Bajaj Chetak and perhaps LML, what was the name of that scooter? I forgot. It was some LML company. So, if you and the Bajaj Chetak parts, they were like so much of the fitting that if that scooter gets something, uska pech leke usme laga dijiye, chalega, daudega, no problem, like that. But to take it to the commercial level there, and there are various organizations we have Biotechnology Industry Research Assistance Council, we have NRDC, we have TFAC there, how they play their role in getting these things together and in a better way, so that our industries are supported. Nowadays, our government is serious about Atmanirbhar, so that we don't depend on others for our products. How that can be? When we support our own industries, our own labs, and the products which they create from them, we can promote them. Otherwise, wahi hota hai. For a user, they need to get the product which is available to them easily. At present, at that time, we don't think, oh, abhi toh theek hai ke that we are boycotting Chinese products. Otherwise, just last year tak hi, wo jo aapne Diwali pe jo ladi khareedne, wo Chinese wali hi sabke ghar mein aa rahi thi. Even Lakshmi, Ganesh, etc., they were coming from China. So those things, they are very important for us. And then the process of enforcing the rules, or in something case, how that adjudication will be taken further in case of protecting the law, how to implement them, keeping them in force there, the various knowledge about it. And ultimately means to develop the human power, the human capital investment, the development of human labor force in this area. And that's why, although at present this field is mostly available in other national law universities courses or law courses or something, but I believe that since it research is an inherent part of all the educational programs, maybe if somebody is doing a MA in education or MEd or something there, or as a part of MPhil, those things, they come up. But I believe that these should, like the environmental sciences, UGC proposed that it be a compulsory course at all the levels, which I certificate level ka hi kyun na ho, chota sa. But normally we don't make ourselves aware even at the institutional level. This is very significant, very important about it. So once we are aware of it, there are various kind of terms which we should be aware of. What are those terms? Like patent, you must have heard about it, and you will be happy that I have also got one in my name. I have pasted the photo of here. This is my team in Brazil. वो भी मैं पाल जी जब मेरा जी मेरा सीवी पढ़ रहे थे दैट इज द बाहिया स्टेट नेशनल बाहिया स्टेट यूनिवर्सिटी बाहिया इज द सेकंड बिगेस्ट स्टेट इन ब्राजील आफ्टर साओ पाउलो एंड देयर वी हैव आवर टीम व्हिच वी वर वर्किंग ऑन वर्चुअल म्यूजियम्स एंड रोल प्लेइंग गेम्स यू मस्ट हैव सीन दोस कंप्यूटर गेम्स इन व्हिच यू अज्यूम द रोल ऑफ समथिंग एंड देन दे आर ऑफ वेरियस काइंड्स The most famous are those you go and keep shooting all those evil creatures from there, something like that. So those kind of things. Try to patent your process or your product so that you can it cannot be misused by others. In academia, we are more concerned with copyright. You generate a knowledge and then you try to protect it. Why? Otherwise, the people and maybe I will show you that slide very soon. You have an idea and somebody steals it. And this is very interesting. Perhaps you may be knowing that in the older times, when the scientists, they are working on a theory, on some equation or some product or some invention or something, you know what they used to do? They used to write a letter to themselves. So you write a letter and it goes to the post office, comes back to you. You write a letter to yourself. And in that case, suppose, me and Manna ji, we have thought of something. और कल को हम दोनों में आपस में लड़ाई हो जाए पंजाब हरियाणा चंडीगढ़ कोर्ट में हम दोनों पहुंच जाएं कि जी ये तो मेरा प्रोडक्ट था इन्होंने चुरा लिया. At that time we need some sort of proof with us. So they used to do that in those times and to have an evidence that look at this time I had created this, developed this, so it belongs to me like that. और आजकल तो बहुत easy हो गया है. What people are doing nowadays? They just send an email to themselves. And the better part here is the email that it has a time stamp into it, which goes up to milliseconds. So yadi mere aur Manna ji ne same cheez pe kaam kiya 12:00 pe, to jaise hi hamari mail chalegi usme wo milli microsecond tak ka hum time dhoond sakte hain ki pehla kaun tha, like that. But this is very important to protect the copyright because it involves the interest of the parties related to it. And means they everybody would like to protect their own thing. But isi ki wajah se hum OER pe pahunchenge kyunki there were some issues related to that. The other thing is the service marks or the trademarks to register them. Aur ye iska ek bada example aapko milega khaskar particularly wo jo title ke ko lekar hota hai in the very famous in our own Bollywood. Aajkal Bollywood waise hi badi charcha mein hai. Due to various reasons, but sometimes there is a tendency of the people to register a name of a movie. वो चाहे उसपे बनाए बिल्कुल ना, but वो title register करके रख लेगा. That then somebody who wants to make that movie, if nobody wants to make movie, फर्क क्या पड़ता है? Register करा के रख लिया. If somebody wants to make movie, they will come to you and will request you कि भाई साहब ये title मेरे को दे दो क्योंकि मैं इसके ऊपर movie बना. And that's why sometimes the things changes. वो राम गोपाल वर्मा जब शोले के ऊपर मूवी बनाना चाह रहे थे तो सिप्पी परिवार ने बड़ा ऑब्जेक्शन किया तो उनको नेम चेंज करना पड़ा और वो पता नहीं शोले की आग और समथिंग और वो बुरी तरह से पिटना ही था उसने. दैट फेल्ड बट दैट इज अ रियल चैलेंज देयर. एंड आपने इसका एक एग्जाम्पल और देखा होगा आप में से जो लोग यूज टू ट्रेवल इन द बस लॉन्ग एगो. नाउडेज नोबडी ट्रेवल्स इन द बस बिकॉज ऑफ वेरियस रीजंस. बट क्या होता था एज सून एज द बस स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द बस स्टेशन और बस स्टैंड समबडी विल एंटर द बस. एक झोला होगा जिसके अंदर 10 रुपए में 5 कंघे या ये कोलगेट ले लीजिए एंड सम पीपल दे विल बाय इट थिंकिंग दैट ओ कोलगेट मिल रही है इतने सस्ते में. बट इफ यू रीड इट वेरी केयरफुली द स्पेलिंग मे बी COLFATE means it may be or KOL, they will use the color, the font size, everything same, will make a minor change somewhere to deceive, to make a counterfeit product. Or aap logon ne North India mein to kafi means winters mein bada hota hai. Customs departments have many times seized the I think that is Borolin cream and its fake products. Anything which gets popular, Manna ji bade popular hain, to Manna ji ke duplicate aa jayenge market ke andar to take the benefit of that, to protect those things. We we try to, you know, protect them there. Then another thing is industrial design. You see, either on the basis of the nature of the material or the design of the material or the comfort which it provides to you. अभी मैं जानता हूँ कुछ लोग तो पलंग पे लेटे हुए होंगे इस सेशन को देखने के लिए, but those who are sitting on a chair, you will find that you and you must have seen many many kind of chair. Although chair का purpose एक ही है कि आपने उसके ऊपर बैठना है, but why the industrial design is more famous? To make your product unique from others. And whether it is, you know, there is a term called as ergonomics. और आप में से जो कंप्यूटर को ज्यादा डील करते होंगे उनको ये ज्यादा अच्छा पता होगा, क्योंकि लॉन्ग टाइम तक माउस को और कीबोर्ड पे टाइप करने से ये जो कार्पल जो हमारा सिंड्रोम है, यू नो, इट गेट्स स्टार्टिंग हर्ट फ्रॉम देयर. टू प्रोटेक्ट इट, टू मेक ए बेटर डिजाइन फॉर इजी यूज, एर्गोनॉमिक्स टू मेक अवर ह्यूमन बॉडी एंड पर्टिकुलरली द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड, टू टेक केयर ऑफ दैट. और इसीलिए आप देखेंगे कि जो ऑफिस चेयर्स होती हैं, आप एक बार दुकान पे चले जाएं कि मुझे ऑफिस चेयर चाहिए, वो आपको इतने सारे डिजाइन देगा, हर एक की इतनी इतनी क्वालिटीज बताएगा, दैट इट बिकम्स अ डिफिकल्ट डिसीजन टू सेलेक्ट व्हाट शुड वी गो. देन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द मटेरियल, नील कमल कुर्सी फेमस हो गई थी एक बार ड्यू टू इट्स डिजाइन एंड वाइट, जो शादी ब्याह में या जो बाहर रखते हैं कभी भी खराब नहीं होगी, दिस दैट एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा. दैट बिकम्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इट गिव्स अ यूनिक आइडेंटिटी टू योर प्रोडक्ट. सिमिलरली to the software design. Vaise this screen which I am showing you right now, it is a screen of my latest MOOC, and you will feel happy that one of our own colleague Dr. Pragat Singh Garcha, who is the principal at GHG College in Ludhiana, perhaps he was my student. There and there were 4861 registered students into it. So the software platforms, we use this platform MOOKit by IIT Kanpur. You have Microsoft Word, so many softwares. In softwares, you protect it so that it should not be misused. But although due to the piracy, I think that is the film industry and the software industry, they are the biggest sufferers of piracy, illicit downloads and those kind of things. Heavy loss. The people, they invest millions and millions of money into develop it, and once it is released, wo shayad aapko yaad hoga X-Men movie mein wo jo last wala unka aaya tha, before it got released, means it was to release, it got leaked into it, even uska final end tak pura edit bhi nahi hua tha, and the people watched it. Once you watch it, who is going to watch into it into the cinema halls? That issue. Another thing is the business models. Various industries, various houses, they have their a specialist kind of a business model, and that makes them different. That makes them either more, you know, successful than others, or have some sort of a unique identity with them. So your what is your business model for that? Say like something, we have our own teaching philosophy. Every person, every one of us, when we teach, we teach in our own unique way. And that's why, you know, one of my student, she is also from Punjab, one day she was telling me that unki beti ko mathematics pasand nahi hai. So I thought that maybe one of the reason maybe that she doesn't like her teacher of mathematics due to some reason. That's why, because if you like your teacher, whatever the subject may be, you may going to like it. So it depends on the methodology, the behavior, the empathy, those things there. What model are we using in education? It is our education model, our teaching model, our learning model, theories of learning, so many things. What fits where? How do we use them in a particular way? there are certain other terms of the similar area which we use, like first party, the originator of that, the holds the first thing. And this first party and the second party, they are around the same thing because they belong to the institution from there. But then you must have heard this name third party. Third party is that which takes the advantage of that, not directly involved into it, but and aap logon ne usko zyadatar jo hum third party kehte hain, so you must have heard that the third party insurance, you know, for your vehicle you need to get it done, or life insurance or health insurance or something. Then you, because third party, it becomes cheaper if you purchase a, you know, say you are buying a car. First time when you buy the car, you get it from the first party, the company which gives it to you. It is a different matter. The company may have tie up with some other Assurance India or LIC or whatever. That is a different matter. But you are getting it from them, directly from there. That's why it is expensive. After 2-3 years, once that term is over and you are free to go anywhere, then we try to go to Policy Bazaar or something which gives us in a much lower economic or the costing package to us. So those, they take it. Then we have the term called as inventors. It can be either as a group, so the team led by, but even if it is a team, then somebody will become the lead inventor. Like Manaji, he is such an expert on online education and MOOCs, etc. And if he creates a software, he creates a philosophy, he creates a process. I believe that he was very much instrumental in that four quadrant model of into it. And when we cite it, we give the credit to him. So he becomes the lead inventor, like something like principal inventor or the principal investigator in case of a research from there. But when that happens, we need to be aware of NDA, non-disclosure agreement. And particularly it becomes very important when we are holding an important position, say like in the ministries or in the defense or something there, the people are supposed to take an oath that even when I will not be in my office in my this capacity, still I cannot reveal or disclose the sensitive information that may be in the national interest or something in business also. Isiliye aapne dekha hoga ki business ke andar poaching, poaching, business poaching, wo bhi bahut hota hai. Log aapko baar baar phone karenge, Coca-Cola wala Pepsi wale ko phone karega ki ji mere yahan aa jao, aapko 1 crore usse zyada dunga. And there have been cases where people have found to be jumping, you know, 2 saal is company mein kaam kiya, knowledge liya, choda usko, dusri jagah pe chale gaye, and like that it happened. That is called as the business poaching there. But definitely nobody would like ki aap kisi ko train kare aur wo fir aapko 2 saal ke baad bye bye satrikal manna ji, I'm going and I'm joining Delhi University, like that. But it happens. There are the things. Then the important term here, another, is called as the licensing. And when particularly when you purchase a software, abhi maine aapko jo ACDC ka jo wo dikhaya tha, they're making it free, so you can download it. That will be legal. Nobody is going to, you know, chase you. But otherwise, you need to purchase the license for a particular software, and that licensing. Similarly, of a product, say in this example, you see the Coca-Cola. It is from a different store. So we licensing Maruti Suzuki. So the technology is created by Suzuki, licensed to Maruti, that Maruti will make these things, and then the product will be launched from here. That kind of licensing. So you have certain sort of an agreement among various parties, where which the originator, the holder of that, gives the license to other party to use it, something like that. There, and then we have a term called as conflict of interest. आप में से जो लोग रिसर्च आर्टिकल लिखते होंगे उनको ये मालूम होगा, और पर्टिकुलरली जो पेपर रिव्यू करते हैं, दैट इफ एन एडिटर हैज रिक्वेस्टेड यू टू रिव्यू ए पेपर, डेफिनेटली मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स दे विल आस्क यू दैट प्लीज डिक्लेयर दैट वेदर यू हैव एनी कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट और पोटेंशियल कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट विद दिस पेपर और नॉट. वो क्या होता है, सपोज, और नॉर्मली तो आजकल जर्नल्स जो हैं वो उसको एनोनिमस बनाने की बोलते हैं. व्हेन यू सबमिट इट, दे विल आस्क द ऑथर्स दैट प्लीज रिमूव योर ऑल आइडेंटिटी. बट उसके बावजूद भी, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ माय ओन एक्सपीरियंस, आई एम द एडिटर ऑफ एशियन जर्नल ऑफ डिस्टेंस एजुकेशन फॉर द पास्ट 17 ईयर्स. बाई रीडिंग एंड बाई नोइंग माई ओन कुलीग्स इन माई एरिया, आई नो दैट हु राइट्स वाट एंड इन वट स्टाइल. So if a paper comes to me, there may be chances that even if they remove their authorship from there, or even the self-citation from the references, still you can find out that this person may be the author. And then this conflict of interest may come. If that person is your friend, you will go a different way. और वो जानी दुश्मन है तो आप बस नहीं जाने दोगे. That way, the conflict of there. This brings us to these things of open educational resources. What happened? That due to the challenges of copyright issues, there as a teacher, as a researcher, as a learner, we need to have the access to the content material. अभी क्या हो गया कि पैसे किसी के पास नहीं है. ना तो टीचर तो खरीद ही नहीं सकता. आपके पास 60 स्टूडेंट है क्लास में. आई डोंट थिंक दैट और एवरी ईयर वो तो चेंज हो जाना है. यू कांट कीप ऑन परचेजिंग बुक्स फॉर देम. सो व्हाट टू डू, यू आस्क द लाइब्रेरी. लाइब्रेरी सेज क्या करें सर, फंड नहीं है हमारे पास, हम कहां से इतनी किताब खरीदेंगे. स्टूडेंट से बोलोगे खुद खरीद लो, वो कहेगा फीस ही देने के पैसे नहीं है हमारे पास, बुक्स कहां से खरीदे. बिकॉज ऑफ द कॉपीराइट नॉलेज होल्डर पाई एंड इन दैट केस देन द नीड फॉर अल्टरनेटिव लाइसेंसेज एंड ओपन एक्सेस came into existence there. Or particularly maine iska background padha tha, and I'm sure that is correct because I read it somewhere, that how it originated. There is this person and his wife was going to the hospital for delivery, and there was some complication into it. So he wanted to, although the doctors were taking care of his wife, but he wanted to learn more about the complication. You know, people, they have self-interest in learning themselves to make them more aware about that ye kya cheez hai ye. And wherever he wanted to search something, either it is asking for the subscription or pay or something not able to see, or institutional mein bolega login karo tab isko padhna. And that time the movement was started that can we make some of the knowledge as open access knowledge. And to go for that, this is for you also. It is a good resource to see the directory of open access journals, and many of these are here in UGC care list also. Although I don't want to discuss UGC care list due to various other parameters into it. Maybe some of you are also not happy with what is there in that list, but anyway, this is a good resource of checking, because here all the articles, they are openly accessible to you. And in many of the journals, if you want to publish your own research, they may be free. There will be no APC, article processing charges, or something into it. And along with, and particularly to me, I think, I believe, Professor Manna may correct me, iska credit Bill Gates ko aur uski company ko jata hai. Microsoft was dominating to such an extent, and it still dominates. There is no question about it. Of the about, I think 95% to 97% of the world machines, they run on, and particularly the PC segment, not the server segments. Although IIS is also there, the proprietary software, and there is nothing wrong in it. At least he started his industry, and that's why this is their business model. But then piracy, starting those things. So a group, a movement of open source software. Started. अभी वंदना जी ने आपको मूडल का वो नाम दिया था. There are, you have the if you are using Firefox, Open Office. If you don't want to use, go for Microsoft Office. You can download this Open Office. You have Fedora. You have Blender, which is a open source 3D animation software. PHP, on which the LAAMP model is based on. LAAMP, Linux, Apache, MySQL, PHP. That is the model for that. You have Java. Those, so many things are there. For these things, for in education or in our normal life, we must thank this gentleman. Any idea who is this? Manna ji nahi bolenge, unko pata hai ye kaun hai. So if you can quickly type the name in the chat box, that who is this person, then great. Otherwise make a guess that who is this. And those of you, even you know him or don't know him, you can silently thank this person. Inki wajah se aaj hamari life mein kitna aaram hai. Wo kaise aaram hai? आप लोग यदि टिकट खरीदना चाहते हो रेलवे का, मुझे नहीं लगता आप रेलवे स्टेशन जाते हो कि चलो अमृतसर रेलवे स्टेशन पे जाना है. यू डू इट योर यूजिंग नो वे. यू नीड टू पे योर बिजली बिल. यू डोंट गो टू द बिजली बोर्ड ऑफिस टू पे योर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बिल और समथिंग. इवन घर में भी आजकल things they commit. He is Sir Tim Berners-Lee, and he is the creator of World Wide Web. Around 30 years ago, he created, and he never patented his invention. Similarly, let me give you another example of Elon Musk. Yeah, the SpaceX wala banda, Elon Musk. He created the electric car framework, and later on, I think just 4 or 5 years ago, he made the patent of his electric car as the open patents. He made them available as open source, because he says that this is a real problem of global warming, and we need zero pollution for that. The electric cars, they are zero pollution cars, but I cannot make the cars for whole of the world. If anybody can take, and similarly, the Volvo company, you know, jab hum aap car mein baithte ho, tab seat belt bandhte ho. The three-pin safety pin was created by Volvo company, and they also released their patents. That's why the other automobile, they could use that, because it is related to the life-saving. It is a life-saving device. That's why there are certain things. Now, this is the famous case of Delhi University and publishers and photocopiers, which went up to the court, because everybody was having some problem with that. The students, they were saying that aap hame padha rahe ho, padhne ke liye koi kitab to de do. Teacher se poochte hain, teacher ke main kahan se laun, mere paas ek hi book hai. Library jao, library mein pahuncho, kahenge ji hamare paas 5 copies hain, baant lo aapas mein. How can 30 students want 5 copies with that? They aur khareed lo, kahan se khareed lo, there is no funds. So what is dhadalle se being doing? That take this book, go to that photocopy shop, get it photocopied, or baant lo aapas mein. But it was hurting the interest, and there I mean, it's a very very long, kai saalon tak chala, ultimately kuch decision hua uske andar. But there is a solution to that problem. The solution is open licenses. What are these open licenses? There are many kind of open licenses. Software industry mein aap log jo hoge aap jante honge, jab hum open inki baat karte to GNU, like Linux or Unix or those things hoti hain, they come into there. Or BSD, Berkeley State, they also issue license. Similarly, in here, in education, for us, we go for Creative Commons licenses, CC license. कहीं पे आपको ये गोले के अंदर CC लिखाई दिखाई देगा, you can understand that this is an open license. It is a sort of a non-profit organization in United States which offered certain 6 kind of licenses. आपको कहीं भी किसी भी किताब के ऊपर, आर्टिकल के ऊपर, वेबसाइट के ऊपर, ब्लॉग के ऊपर, वीडियो के ऊपर, कहीं पे भी ये ऐसे निशान दिखें, तो इसका क्या मतलब है कि आप इस मटेरियल को बिना परमिशन मांगे यूज कर सकते हो. बिकॉज इन हेयर द परमिशन इज ऑलरेडी गिवन. यदि मन्ना साहब ने एक आर्टिकल लिखा आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस के ऊपर, और उन्होंने उसको किसी भी इनमें से किसी भी एक सीसी लगा के रिलीज कर दिया, सो यू डोंट नीड टू कॉल हिम कि सर ਤੁਸੀਂ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਆਰਟੀਕਲ ਯੂਜ਼ ਕਰਨਾ ਸੀ ਪਰਮਿਸ਼ਨ ਦੇ ਰਹੇ ਹੋ. ਨੋ ਨੀਡ, ਪਰਮਿਸ਼ਨ ਹੀ ਹੈਜ਼ ਆਲਰੇਡੀ ਗਰਾਂਟਡ ਇਟ. ਇਨ ਕਾਪੀਰਾਈਟ, ਇਫ ਯੂ ਵਾਂਟ ਟੂ ਯੂਜ਼ ਇਟ, ਯੂ ਨੀਡ ਟੂ ਓਬਟੇਨ ਦੀ ਪਰਮਿਸ਼ਨ. ਸੋ ਵਨ ਸਟੈਪ, ਐਂਡ ਦੈਟ ਇਜ਼ ਅ ਵੈਰੀ ਬਿਗ ਸਟੈਪ. ਕਾਪੀਰਾਈਟ ਕੇ ਅੰਦਰ ਉਹ ਆਪਸੇ ਬੋਲੇਗਾ ਕਿ ਜੀ ਖਰੀਦ ਲਓ, ਮੈਂ ਨਹੀਂ ਦੇ ਸਕਦਾ ਆਪਕੋ. ਔਰ ਪਾਰਟਿਕੁਲਰਲੀ ਯਦਿ ਕੋਈ ਆਥਰ ਹੈ ਤੋ ਕਿਉਂ, ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਉਸਕਾ ਕਾਪੀਰਾਈਟ ਹੋਲਡਰ ਹੈ ਰੁਟਲੇ ਕੇ ਪਾਸ ਹੋਗਾ, ਵਾਈਵਾ ਕੇ ਪਾਸ ਹੋਗਾ, ਵਿਕਾਸ ਪਬਲੀਕੇਸ਼ਨ ਕਿਸੇ ਨਾ ਕਿਸੇ ਪਬਲੀਕੇਸ਼ਨ ਕੇ ਪਾਸ ਹੋਗਾ. ਪਬਲੀਕੇਸ਼ਨ ਹਾਊਸ ਮੇ ਜਾਓਗੇ ਤੋ ਆਪਕੋ ਬੋਲ ਦੇਗਾ ਕਿ ਜੀ ਖਰੀਦ ਲਓ. You can't खरीद there. That is the benefit here. But इसके अंदर अब ये आता है कि permission तो मिल गई, लेकिन permission करने के बाद जो author है, जो owner है, वो कितना comfortable है कि आप उसको किस form के अंदर आप use करोगे. That makes the difference. That and these are the 6 things. Very quickly I will just explain. There are 4 parameters into it. There, BY, always acknowledge. If you don't acknowledge it, you may be doing plagiarism or IPR theft. इंटेलेक्चुअल, वैसे इन दोनों में बड़ा फर्क है, प्लेगरिज्म के अंदर और आईपीआर कॉपीराइट वायलेशन के अंदर. क्या डिफरेंस है दोनों के अंदर? एक में नैतिकता आती है, एथिक्स आता है, एक के अंदर आप लॉ ब्रेक कर रहे हो, आप कानून भंग कर रहे हो एक के अंदर. दैट इज द डिफरेंस. प्लेगरिज्म, देर इज नो नीड फॉर दैट. ऑलरेडी बोल दिया उन्होंने कि जी यूज कर लो, आपको खाली नाम ही तो बोलना है कि मन्ना जी ने 2020 में इस आर्टिकल को लिखा था, हम उसको सर दें. There should not be any problem in that. After that, NC stands for non-commercial. उसके बाद बंदे ने आपको बोला कि जी आप इसको मार्केट में जाके बेच सकते हो कि नहीं बेच सकते हो. बेच सकते हो पूरा कीजिए, जहां पर एनसी लिख दिया उस मटेरियल को नहीं बेच सकते, फिर वो हो गया नॉन कमर्शियल, और जहां पे एनडी लग गया नो डेरिवेटिव, मींस यूज करना है तो ऐसे ही यूज करना है, यू कैन नॉट रिवाइज इट। तो जिस भी लाइसेंस के अंदर एनडी नहीं लिखा, आप उसको डाउनलोड करके चेंज कर सकते हो अपने हिसाब से। मैं आपको वेबसाइट्स दिखाऊंगा हमारे पास टाइम होगा अभी, या वी हैव सम टाइम विद अस, सो आई विल शो यू सम लाइव वेबसाइट्स फ्रॉम देयर, वी कैन चेक दीज थिंग्स। सो एनसी नॉन कमर्शियल, जहां पे एनसी लिखा गया कमर्शियल यूज नहीं कर सकते, जहां पे एनसी नहीं लिखा उसका इवन आप कमर्शियल यूज भी कर सकते हो। यदि मन्ना जी ने कोई एक बुक लिखी जिसके ऊपर सीसी बाई लगा के उन्होंने उसको कम्युनिटी को दे दिया, आप वेरी वेल उस किताब को प्रिंट करके यदि आप उसका कमर्शियल यूज में भी चाहें, मीन्स कमर्शियल यूज उतना नहीं है कि आप उसको वैसे कर दें, आप अपने स्टूडेंट्स को नॉमिनल प्राइस के ऊपर आप इशू कर सकते हो, नो प्रॉब्लम टू इट। एंड दिस देयर इज वन मोर SA, SA स्टैंड्स फॉर शेयर अलाइक। शेयर अलाइक आपको ये कहता है, जैसे विकीपीडिया की एंट्री आप देखो, विकीपीडिया के ऊपर आप जाओ, विकीपीडिया हैज बिकम द वर्ल्ड्स लार्जेस्ट ऑनलाइन एनसाइक्लोपीडिया, उसके ऊपर जितना भी पेज के एंड पे आप देखेंगे CC BY SA लिखा होता है। उसका क्या मतलब है कि ऐसा मटेरियल जिसके ऊपर CC BY SA है आप उसको यूज कर सकते हो, लेकिन आपको उसी लाइसेंस को ही रिटेन करना पड़ेगा, आप चेंज नहीं करेंगे आप उसको, क्योंकि तो आपने खुद भी उसका बेनिफिट लिया है, आप आगे सोसाइटी को सेम लाइसेंस की तरह ही आप उसको आगे बांटिए। तो ये इसके फीचर्स हैं, आपको हर किसी चीज के अंदर एट्रीब्यूट करना है, साइट करना है, नाम देना है, एक्नॉलेज करना है, रेफरेंसेस में जाएगा वो, एनसी में है तो कमर्शियल यूज नहीं होगा, एनडी है तो एडिट नहीं होगा, और ऐसे है तो सेम लाइसेंस आगे फॉरवर्ड रहेगा। ये लाखों के अंदर, करोड़ों के अंदर आपको मेटेरियल मिल जाएंगे। फंडामेंटल हमारा यहाँ पर है, जब हम OER की बात करते हैं, देयर इज नो नीड फॉर यू टू री इन्वेंट द व्हील, नो नीड। यदि आप कोई ऑनलाइन कोर्स बनाना चाहते हैं, इवन स्वयं के ऊपर भी आप इसको, इसके बाद के ऊपर जोर दिया गया है कि ओपन सोर्सेज चीजों को यूज कीजिए आप, और ओपन सोर्स में तो ऑलरेडी किसी ने बना रखा, आपको तो उसको यूज ही करना है। अभी वंदना जी भी आपको बता रहे थे कि मॉडल के अंदर आप उसको डाउनलोड करके यूनिफाइड LMS जो हमने बनाना है कि हम अपना किस तरीके से चीज को बना सकते हैं, तो कोड है ना आपके पास, आप कोड को लेके उसको वो कर लीजिए। सो नो नीड फॉर यू टू रीराइट एवरीथिंग फ्रॉम द स्टार्ट, देयर आर मेनी मेनी प्लेटफॉर्म्स अवेलेबल ऑन विच यू कैन फाइंड ऑल दीज थिंग्स। मिलियंस के अंदर, करोड़ों के अंदर, तादाद के अंदर चीजें इतनी भरी पड़ी हैं कि आप यदि ढूंढना चाहेंगे तो कुछ ना कुछ मिल ही जाएगा। नहीं मिलता है तो आपके लिए गोल्डन अपॉर्चुनिटी है कि आप क्रिएट कर दो उसके लिए, और जहां पर आपको लगता है कि कोई गैप है, ताकि और लोग यूज कर सकें। इसका सिंपल सा एक एग्जाम्पल आपको देता हूं मैं। न्यूटन को हम अपने इस एज का वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट साइंटिस्ट मानते हैं। उन्होंने एक बार अपने आप ही ये बोला था कि ऐसा नहीं है कि मैंने ही किया तो और किसी ने कुछ नहीं किया। In my case, I was so successful because I could do these things because I was standing on the shoulders of giants. Standing on the shoulders of giants. That's why. Research में आप लोग भी यही करते हो। एक एक हर किसी के अंदर mostly वो chapter number 2 होता है, review of related literature. उसको क्यों किया जाता है? देखने के लिए कि आप किसी का काम repeat तो नहीं कर रहे। आप ही जो कर रहे हो किसी और ही ने कर रखा है तो फिर आपको करने की जरूरत क्या है? You need to find a gap. And that's why we receive that knowledge, because somebody created for us and we are using it. So we are standing on the shoulders of giants. So इससे आपको ज्यादा दूर का दिखता है। आप जमीन पे खड़े हो तो कम दिखता है, ऊपर जाते हो तो ज्यादा दिखता है आपको। That way, these are so many platforms available which allow us to use that. दुनिया के लगभग तमाम देश इसके ऊपर राजी हैं, क्रिएटिव कॉमन्स लाइसेंस को एग्री करते हैं, इंक्लूडिंग इंडिया, वी आर ऑल्सो पार्टी टू दैट। वर्ल्ड का आपको ऑलमोस्ट हर लैंग्वेज के अंदर आप जिस भी चाहें उसमें बनाना चाहें आपको मिल जाएगा। हमारा अपना इंडियन प्लेटफॉर्म भी है जिसके ऊपर ऑल इंडियन लैंग्वेजेस द थिंग्स दे आर अवेलेबल टू अस। दीज आर द एक्सप्लेनेशंस, आई डोंट गो इनटू इट, बट सिंपली मैंने आपको बता दिया था कि किसमें क्या। इसको पढ़ने से आपको पता लग जाएगा कि इसके तीन फॉर्मेट होते हैं इसको डिफाइन करने के, मशीन रीडेबल, ह्यूमन रीडेबल एंड लीगल लाइसेंस। तो इतना लंबा होता है कोई कभी नहीं पढ़ता। आपने आज तक जितनी भी ऐप डाउनलोड की होंगी, जितने भी सॉफ्टवेयर अलाउड होंगे, मैं गारंटी ले रहा हूँ आपने कभी किसी का नहीं पढ़ा होगा। यू जस्ट हैव, और आजकल तो इतना हो गया कि जब तक आप एग्री नहीं करोगे वो इंस्टॉल ही नहीं होगा। अब डिस एग्री कर रहे हो तो कहेगा बाय बाय, आई एम नॉट इंस्टॉलिंग इट, सो यू हैव टू एग्री इट।
interrupting you just one second. Sorry, very sorry. My most of the participants from the south side, if you will be most of the time in English, they will be comfortable. Sorry, sir. Sorry.
Okay. I was not aware. I thought that aapke hi side ke honge. Okay. So in that case, you know, it becomes very important for us to follow those things. These licenses, they are defined, they are declared in three formats. The machine readable means if the license is there, you know, that barcode machine which is there and that reads it, it lets you know that what kind of that it holds. The most easy which we use is the human readable. You just see the logo, just see the icon, the image, and you will understand what is meaning of CC, BY, and C that way. And the legal code is lengthy code. If something goes wrong, that is for the courts to make the interpretation from there. This is the spectrum. This is the range in which we deal into the education field. On one side, education, not only in terms of their education means teaching, learning, research field, where we want to learn either as formal or informal, non-formal, in any way possible there. On the one side, we have the public domain materials. Nobody holds the copyright of them. On the another side, it is completely all rights reserved, the completely copyright protected material, which cannot be used unless you are obtaining it legally. You are authorized to use that. Otherwise, in between these Creative Commons licenses come. There is one more license which comes in between public domain and CC BY. That is CC 0. CC 0 is what? That the in public domain, there is no copyright holder. And mostly like Ramayan, Mahabharat, stories of Munshi Premchand, etc., they go into the public domain because mostly either the, you know, it differs from country to country. After the death of the persons of 75 years, I think in India it is 70 or 75 or something like that, then the material, if the copyright has not been transferred to the here explicitly, it will become public domain material. Nobody. In CCBY, the person is there and the person declares that I'm waiving off all my copyright claims on that. You can use it. So that makes it CC0. Within that, these six, they are there. And from the public domain, the most easy one, the least restrictive one, up to the most restrictive, goes towards create the copyright protected content. So that is the range, from the most simple up to the most complex one. The last two licenses of CCBY, we do not call them OER, Open Educational Resources, because you can't revise them. You can't make use of them in an edited mode that way. This is how we use them. You can see if you find a blog and the author has put the logo in there. So that is, means you can use it now, depending on what authority has been released for the use of that. This is a computational neuroscience course by Paul G. Allen School in US, and they have released the whole course for you. What we can do it for here, that we can, you know, try finding a gap and create it, or we can update an existing open resource which is there. We can share our materials with us and share it. Like nowadays, if you go to a particular a good research journal, the articles are available in various formats. You may find it is available in PDF, HTML, EPUB, MS Doc. Sometimes they don't give the MS Doc, but they try to give it, or XML format there. So variety, because the person may not have the relevant software to open that particular file from there. This is an example of how we do it. Suppose you want to write a course. For that course, you have collected materials from different sources, which are Creative Commons licensed materials. What you can do, you will first, from your raw materials, you will create your first version. Once that is ready and you release it, others, what they can do, they can repurpose them, means make the things reorganized, add to your design, take out something from your design, remix the pieces and something, and make the other project. Let me give you an example. Say, for example, Mahira ji has written a poem. Now Manna ji thinks that, okay, on that poem, can I make a drama? Very well, yes, you can do it, because it is released with an open license. So the poem gets transferred to a drama. Now, after that, Manjit ji is present, and Manjit thinks that, can I make a movie on this? Very well, if it is with creative, with open license, that can be done because there is no copyright challenge into it. So you can transform, then you can translate it into different language. If it is available in Punjabi, you can translate it into English or something like that. Those things, they are possible here. Now you can see the power, that what power it offers you. But the question arises that if you are using these things, how do you know that it is of a good quality? So this British Columbia, the open campus there, they have given this evaluation criteria, 10 parameters. Not necessarily all 10 should exist in that content, but it gives a fair idea that how much comprehensive it is, how much accurate it is, what is its relevance, the clear language, there is consistency in the structure or not, and those things. On the basis of this, you can evaluate it, whether you are using the content of someone else, to find out whether that is a quality content or not for that. But when you use it, you need to cite it, because BY is there, you need to tell it. You are using it, how do we use it? Just remember this formula called as TASL. T stands for title, title of that work. Every work will have some title. Every object which exists there, they have a title. We give the names to everyone. In humans, we have our name. Everything has a title. So the title of that author, who is the owner of that, who is the holder of that, who created that, the source. If it is the print source, you have that thing. If it is online source, you can make it hyperlink. And which license, out of those six licenses, which license it holds, TASL. That is very super simple. How it is done? In this way. Suppose Andrea, this is her book. So the dog training Bible, made the dog sit there, take the photograph, and released it as CC BY. At that time, it was the version 2 of the Creative Commons license, so it was released with that. Later on, after that, Christine used that image because it is CC BY. CC BY allows you to revise the photograph. So she put another photograph on the top of that book and took another photograph, released it now with CC BY 4.0, and that way, by citing the other work. This way, you know, we use this and we go with this. I think if there are any questions, I can answer them. Otherwise, I will switch to some of the live websites where I can show you that from where we can get these materials which are easily available to us. We still have some time with us. Okay, are there any questions, or should I go and change my screen?
Yes, sir. I think most of the queries which were coming, even I was addressing on your behalf. And
oh, wonderful. Thank you so much.
So somebody was asking for a zero. Yeah, in the Creative Commons, about the
CC0.
Yeah.
CC0 is that, suppose you, somebody's microphone was on. If some,
yeah.
Content, and then they think that I'm releasing it without, in even CC BY, the copyright is still retained, you know, that comes by default. Whenever a person creates anything, like there is a journal, it is called as education and science development, but if you submit your article to that, it will ask you, it will tell you that you are the copyright holder of it. Some journals, they ask you to transfer the copyright also to the publisher, to the editor. But that journal says that you retain your copyright. You just give us the license to reproduce your work on our platform. So that is the clarity from there. In CC0, the person who has created that work releases all the copyrights also. So it becomes, in a way, waving off. They are saying that, I'm not holding, but the person is still present. In public domain, like we don't have Munshi Premchand with us nowadays, and the people who wrote Ramayana, Mahabharata, and those things, no, means in our country also. Perhaps you can check it on the internet, what is the lifetime of that, whether it is the after the death of the person, after 65 years or 70 or what, it goes into, then it becomes public domain. But here the person is still existing among us. They are releasing their copyright. That way you can make it. So
thank you, sir.
The difference here between CC BY and CC BY, CC BY, you still need to cite the person. But in CC 0, there is no one to cite it. Jay, another question.
Yeah. The figure from a published work, if it has to be used by someone with the proper citation, is allowed or not? Or he has to seek permission from author or publisher? This is one question. I think,
can you please repeat the question?
I'll repeat. It's regarding the publication. Figure from a published work, if has to be used by someone with the proper citation, is allowed or not? Or he has to seek a permission from author or publisher? Yeah.
If it is copyright material, say like if it is a copyright book, then definitely we need the permission from the publisher or the author, whoever is the copyright holder of that. Not even a single word technically we can use it. However, there is a way out, which we call it as fair use policy. Under the fair use policy, some portion, maybe basically we say 10% of that content can be taken, but for academic purposes only, not for commercial purpose. Commercial purpose, absolutely no for that. But it is always a good idea to obtain the permission and then use it, because that is protected by them.
Yeah, very interesting question, sir. I think I faced many times this kind of questions because I was in AICT. Sir, if any institute has my lecture video without declaration of IPR, then if I leave that institute, can they use my video afterwards? Yes, many of the faculty members do writing emails to the AICT, UGC. Sir, they are using my content. I left that. They have not given me 3 months salary even, and I am in another domain or something. So I think you are the right person to put a light on this area also. Yeah.
Technically, basically, when we are employed with some organization, and at that time, if we are creating some content, that becomes the property of that institution. Whether you stay there or not, they are free to use that till they want to use that. So even if you leave it, then if you want to go with that kind of thing, then you need to either patent it in your name, go for that kind of the technical things. In that case, wherever you will go, your patent will follow you. But otherwise, this content, I'm sorry, but because yes. you were part of that institution at that time, you were not as individual, because you use the identity of the institution also. So it will stay with that.
It's a both way, sir. I'll give you one more interesting things happening. Suppose I worked in one institution and they given me full support to go abroad and applying for the patents, I researched papers and wrote on books. When my biodata got improved, I applied to other institution. They are looking for a NAC or NBA because they want that biodata profile. They say, okay, we'll give you 1.5 lakh package. You come and join, because your all credentials are coming along with you. We will get a marks in criteria 2 and criteria 3 of NAC. As well as this is the common story. It's a both way. Sometimes the institutions make a misuse of the content which is retained there, or sometimes the faculty, although the institution previously have paid them a huge money to be going for the patent fee and all this kind of conferences part also there. One more thing is happening is the self plagiarism. Can you speak some few words about the self plagiarism?
Self plagiarism. Actually, what the people do, they have the habit of, in H index there, it doesn't add any value to that self citation. There is a, let me find. It's a very interesting case of. Let me try to find out. Here it is. You see, this is one wonderful example on this case. There is a scientist, his name is you may be knowing that H index was devised by John Hitch. That's why it is called as H index. Yes, exactly. Which is an indication of your standing suppose you have written 20 publications and they have been cited 100 times, so your H index becomes 20, something like that. Let me find the name of that person who has okay, Raoult. Now what he did here in Web of Science database, Raoult has 2053 articles published between this time to this time, having received a total of 72,000 citations. His H index is 120. उसके कंपैरिजन में यदि आप आइंस्टाइन का देखेंगे तो आइंस्टाइन ने टोटल 1901 से लेके 1995 ड्यूरेशन ही गॉट ओनली 147 आर्टिकल्स व्हिच अट्रैक्टेड 1564 साइटेशंस ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट फार्मूला इफ यू कैलकुलेट इट इट्स ओनली 1.7 मींस द सेल्फ साइटेशंस बट व्हाट ही डिड नाउ लेट अस सी द केस ऑफ हिम. The database indicated that the total citations attributed to the co-authored, out of these 18,000 were self-citations. Either he was solo author or co-author or something. So if you deduct, and this amounts to 25%, so the H index will drop from 120 to 104 there.
Okay.
Self-citation is not preferred in academia. The people, you may be adding to your own thing, but those people who are in the academia, they know that you are not able to go beyond yourself. That's why every time you are citing yourself in that case, it is the point that others should cite you rather that you are self promoting yourself.
They should value to your work.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This article is and let me maybe I can paste it in the chat. You can on your free time you can surf read it there. Ji, next.
Yeah, so it does mean that if we are going to use our own content in a future coming publications more than certain limit, it is known to be as a self plagiarism. Am I right, sir?
Yes,
because
basically, on a level of it depends on what are total references you are quoting or the content. In a way, one or two of self citations can be given, no problem. But if the person is citing himself or herself more than 4 or 5, definitely that may raise eyebrows.
Yes. Because sometimes we do one thing. We publish in parts, to be make more number of papers in a quantity. Already we have done one experimental work and let A to be published here, then B along with the A feedback, then AB feedback. So many papers I've seen some of my, because sometimes we go for some unicorn kind of evaluation of NAC as an NBA. So we could see, we can correlate. So the work has been done somewhere in 10 years back, but he's still publishing the work, because he wants to get the more papers to be get published, to be get some kind of, the profile upgradation or other reasons. This can be. So really, sir, it was a unique lecture today delivered by you. I'm sure, including me, all the participants, there were so many new takeaways, because most of my teachers, they were not aware about the Creative Commons, because when SWAM was going to be launched, it was the first time I discovered what is CC BY-NA, because SWAM was for the CC BY-NA. I especially met two, three very good advocates, and Sony Ji, one of the Supreme Court advocate. I sat along with him for 2 days because of legal vetting was going on for the biggest platform of the world, that is a MOOCs platform, SWAM. So then I realized how we are unaware, and being a teacher, because I think the best content can be given by teachers only. Then only it comes to the lyrics and the movie songs. Now every day we are reading on the newspaper, he's stolen my song and he's stolen my composing, why he is using my song title or maybe even a movie title or even my dialogue also. If they are so cautious because they have a money mind, why about the teachers not? Because today reinventing of wheel is happening, sir. I still remember till this internet world was not there and we start our PhD, I used to go to IIT Roorkee to get the photocopies of the journals to do the literature review. And I was not knowing that something in adjacent to my college, somebody is pursuing the same kind of research. By the time the thesis came for a evaluation, the my examiner, who's supposed to be go for a viva, he called me personally, Manna, this same kind of thesis my student is doing in my college at Thapar. So how, sir, then your that thing helped a lot to me, sir. You know, luckily, one of my friend, he made drafting corrections. That email was with me. I brought that email to Professor Bhimra. He was a Thapar professor. Still, I remember the name because I was doing. Then he scolded his guy. Then that guy was innocent. He was not aware about this, that Manna is doing in slide Tongua, same is happening in Thapar. He innocent. And I said, sir, no problem. I have a good sufficient thesis data. I can change my topic. I can change a little bit. Let him do because he is already late in 3 years and he may miss his train because for me. So I delayed my thesis of M.Tech 6 months for that reason. And I allowed that guy, that is a humanitarian ground. But yes, it was the very conscious step taken by the good professors. They are very much aware because if that time it could have been happened, sir, later some of the degree is going to be get on a stake, either mine degree or his degree. That I do. So that's why I just putting this live example to all my participants who are listening to me. This session was amazing, sir. Very informative. We should be, because tomorrow when they are going for the MOOCs creation, you know, each and every video content, which they are not going to put on a YouTube and it is going to be through SWAM or through any kind of a Coursera or maybe edX, they should be aware about it is a copyright. They must have a royalty. If they have having a royalty, then the publisher or agency who's going to be taken of this, they can make use of this. So that's amazing. I really really grateful to you. I think most of the participants, they are writing here on the chat box, very informative session. Thank you, sir. Great session, and all this kind of feedback is keep coming and on the chat box. So thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
If you are not feeling hungry, just give me 5 minutes. Very quickly, sir. I want to show.
I think everybody hear you more from you, sir. Please take 5 minutes. Thank you.
I want to show some of the websites from where you can freely use the content. No copyright, no police will chase you. So those things. I think let's first start with the people who started all this movement. And they were the leaders into it. So this is MIT, not Maharashtra Institute of Technology, the real MIT here. Are the people who somewhere in 2000 they started with. You can you can find the full course and everything, the new courses which are available there. And you can, you know, say for example on chemical engineering, you can see undergraduate level, etc., principles of microeconomics. You can download this. It offers you the assignments, the lecture notes, everything fully free from here. We have one example in India, NROER. This gives you in major Indian languages the various kind of materials. Let the page come. It is taking time. It's saying transferring data. Okay, in the meantime, I will show you. Another website which I want you to search is Athabasca University Press. And one book I want to show you everyone, because we all are in online business now, you must download that book. Here is the, let me see, no, NROER website. Please go to NROER on your machine and from there you can use that. So here it is, Athabasca University Press. You can click on subject. And you see, or there is one more interesting example with this Athabasca University Press. When this university decided to offer their content as open access, open educational resources, the finance department, they were having some apprehensions that our revenue will be affected. You know what happened? When they released their material, their revenue increased. And they all were surprised, pleasantly surprised. What happened? The happening was, let me give you an example to which I am also a party. Many of you may remember that not so long ago, but sometimes ago, when you were preparing for your IAS examination, IFS examination, those kind of examinations, you used to buy NCERT material. Yes, many people I know, we used to go to the NCERT library, the book house there in the NCERT premises, and purchase the books there with the thing that, because NCERT books were so well written that you read them and then you can prepare your UPSC kind of examinations. Later on, that slot was grabbed by IGNU. So people used to come to me when I was regional director of IGNU, that sir kindly give us the history set or economic set. Why? Because we are preparing for examinations. But how this course is helping you? No, sir, these books are very well written and we read them and we can find everything. So you become a brand image. Here, same thing happened. When the people, they used these books, they found that wonderful books. So it means their other material will also be good. And they started purchasing. And these are the soft copies which they were offering, not the printed copies. If you want print copies, they will still give you, but they will charge a nominal fee from you, the printing cost actually, to meet the cut. I want to show you this. You can see all these subjects on the screen right now. Go to anyone, download all open source as there. I want to show you this education online. I hope you can see now this quiz. And nowadays online assessment is very popular. Download this book. These are all free books. I want to bring you to this award winning book by Manna ji, jante honge Terry Anderson professor, wonderful person from Canada. There he has written this book of theory and practice of online. You can download, this is award winning book. This book has been downloaded in PDF and translated in more than 60 languages of the world. This is in English, but it has been translated into other languages. You can see it has four parts. It tells you theory, it tells you infrastructure, it tells you design online courses and delivery and assessment part. And see here, this book is under Creative Commons. You cannot make a commercial use, but you can reproduce it for your own students and give them. And similarly, many other, you will find so many subjects available there. Two more websites which will be good for you. One is OpenStax. And those of you who are from engineering or those subjects, you are going to love this website. These are full 100% free textbooks, not articles, complete textbooks. You can see the subjects here, mathematics, science, social science, humanities, etc. You click on anyone here, peer reviewed, openly licensed, 100% free. Say this book is on history. You can click on it and then can download the PDF. Not only that, if you think that out of 10 chapters, only 2 chapters are required for you, it depends on the license. Let us say this is CCBY. BY means you are allowed to revise the chapters. Download it, modify it to your need, and use that, completely allowed under 4.0. Another one, it is Open Textbook Project of Hong Kong. Here, this site offers books for all the levels. Bachchon se leke, from primary up to the tertiary, find and wonderful books. Hey, let me just quickly show you. Okay, here you can see the subjects. I'm just clicking on business. So accountancy, and you can read it. This is one of the free open textbook for tertiary level. Please feel free to use it, adopt it, and modify the content to your own needs. The only request which they say, please read it, release it with data, because you used it for there, and it is CCBY-SA. That's only thing which request. So if you are teaching accountancy, use this book. You don't need to write it. You want to create your video, use the content into it and create your own video for that. So whole list is there. So this is about the text. There are many others also. I'm just showing you the major from which you can download them. Now let me show you. You want to make PPT, you want to create your course. For that you need images. What we do, we go to the Google, make a search, find, oh, this image is very good, let me download it. That's a wrong approach. You can't do that. You should not do that actually. What should we do in that case? There are certain websites which help you. One is Pixabay. There, see here, stunning free image, royalty free stock. And say, for example, if you want to search something on leaf, you just type your leaf. You want to make give some lesson on, say, photosynthesis, and you think that, okay, this image is good, I want to show that how that is used. So you click on that particular image and see on the right, it says here free for commercial use, and one step further, no attribution required. It means the author is here, what is the name, jo bhi name hai, but if you want to use this image, you want to print it, make it a banner and go to Lal Qila and sell it in 10 rupees, perfectly fine with this person or with this platform. And secondly, if you don't want to cite even, go ahead. Ethically, however, I will request you that please, you can at least give this URL if you are using, making your own present. So that is the ethical issue. There is no shame and harm in acknowledging the work of someone else if we are using that in our work there. So Pixabay. Another site which I use very regularly is Unsplash. And here you can see internet source of freely usable images. And from the here on the upper top,